Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Archangel Nexus, and I'm back with another video. We talk games in this house, and the house always wins. Now today I want to talk about this article by Tech for Gamers. They're talking about how PlayStation is late to the live service party, that they've missed the live service train entirely. Here's the shit. We ain't been asleep this whole time, right? These consoles have been out for a while now. Modern consoles have been going at it since a long time ago. When I say modern consoles, I mean consoles as we know it today, starting from the first live service console, the Xbox. Alright? Now the article goes into different details. I've been wanting to talk about this article for a minute, by the way. Article goes into different details about why and how this happened. But there's a lot that it doesn't actually mention that we were all here for. Alright? First things first, Microsoft debuted their Xbox. Let's just go into the name. It's called Live Service for a reason. Alright? It's called Live Service. Not just because of what it does, but because of Xbox Live. When you think live service, you think Xbox. And the reason you think Xbox is because they've been on this since jump. They was on this off rip since before anybody took them seriously on it. In fact, many joked on the things that they had planned all this time. When they came out with the Xbox, the original one, PlayStation 2, we were playing SOCOM on PlayStation. And we had, this was just off the heels of Phantasy Star on Dreamcast, right? So there were gamers out there on console that clearly wanted to spend many hours playing a single game. I mean, you could even argue going all the way as far back as GoldenEye on N64, that people were hungry to play these games on console for many, many hours. And I bring this up because when you go far back enough, you'll see that these people were always there, right? So as console games development and games development overall became more and more expensive, certain changes had to be made in order for you to keep up with the business, you see? And this is where I think PlayStation really missed the train, because when PS2 came out and the Xbox came out, PS2 preceded the Dreamcast. They saw how popular Phantasy Star was, and yet the console didn't really get a whole lot of online killer apps. It got a ton of really amazing single player games, but when it came to that online killer, that joint that's gonna attract people and keep them paying for a subscription, you had to look no further than Xbox for that. And that's where Xbox planted its first flag, where they came out and they was like, we're a live service console. Let everybody else be what they wanna be. We're gonna be this. And then 360 came out and they took it even further. Their live service grew even further. They created a store. They took ideas from the Halo dashboard and ideas from inside the Halo game itself and the online features and their Xbox Live services early on, and they turned it into what we got in the 360. We got store, we got apps, we got Netflix, we got social with Facebook, right? We got achievements, achievement points. All of this came to Xbox early because they was on the cutting edge of this ever since day one. And then came along the Xbox One. And this is where Sony made their next mistake. You see, Microsoft and Sony was supposed to both step on that stage and reveal two games as a service consoles both with social features. And at the same time where both companies was going to start focusing on not only making games, but also developing film. Movies and TV shows that are about their games. Now, this was probably a decision that they were both making, maybe not even knowing that the other one was making this decision. But something tells me that Microsoft knew that Sony was going to do something similar. So they decided to go first. They took all of the heat for everything that was relating to their games as a service plan. There's so much that even got misconstrued by the media when they spoke about what their plans were. A lot of the stuff that they said that they were going to do, they even openly said it's not set in stone. This is just, we're just talking about some of these things. And people reacted in a way like the whole entire future of Xbox was going to be ruined over this. But they kept pushing forward. And they kept building onto their games as a service, and they learn from their mistakes and they listen to fans. They did this all the way up until today, where Sony finally admits that all of their pillars of success are outdated, that they're gonna have to start cutting down on games development. And this is all on the heel of them saying that their business is in danger because of the Activision Blizzard King deal. And why do you think that is? It's pretty obvious. Microsoft is making big moves. They're becoming a multi-trillion dollar company because all of their businesses are succeeding underneath them. And Xbox is making billions of dollars and is buying up all these games because of games as a service. Games as a service is a bit messy because it's really hard to find your audience. It's expensive. But once you do, you can take that and you can pay off all of the ideas that your devs have. You can allow them to do pretty much whatever they want. They can realize their dreams. They can build the games that they want to build. They can put out DLC for cheap or free. They can drop the prices to their game. They can even afford to make a sequel even before the previous one made money. And they've already made their money by that point because of the subscription fee. Devs are closing their doors left and right across the industry. Games are being canceled. The games as a service on Xbox is doing well. Now, why would Sony come out and say that their pillars of success is outdated if they wasn't talking about their focus? And when you go back to the Xbox One launch, Sony came out and said, hey, we're not doing what these guys are doing. We're doing what this, we're doing this. We're doing what our fans want. We're doing the same thing that we've always done. And the one thing that they needed all of this time is for games as a service to fill their wallet so that they can keep pumping out single player games at the same rate that they always have. And yet now we're seeing them cut down that rate. This was a big deal. And you might wonder who the hell is to blame for this. Some people might say that it's Sony's fault, bad business, whatever, blah, 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 and that's the reason why this is happening. But I don't blame Sony even one bit. I blame their fan base. It's really PlayStation fans that are to blame for this. A lot of people don't like hearing that gamers are to blame for anything, and they want the corporation to take full responsibility. But when you got thousands of gamers flooding the internet to tell Microsoft, this is a terrible idea. We don't want this. We don't want microtransactions. We don't want DRM. We don't want games as a service, essentially, before it had its name. When you got gamers coming out and saying this, and Sony sees this, the natural reaction is going to be, all right, maybe we should back off this and just do what they say. But now it's 2024, and the fruits of Microsoft's and Xbox's investment is finally showing up. We have a game service where essentially you're paying $15 a month to play your favorite games. And you can play them anytime you want. You don't have to buy the next console. You can play it off xCloud. When the game's about, if any game comes off of Game Pass, they give you a nice huge chunk of time to buy it on a discount right before it comes off. There's all types of benefits to getting on Game Pass. And now you see PlayStation's looking back and they're kicking themselves in the ass like, God damn. We could have used some microtransactions in Warhawk, actually. Maybe Killzone could have used a partnership with some other characters from other games. Maybe get some skins in there. Now they're thinking, damn, those motherfuckers at Xbox was up to something this whole time and we didn't even know it. This is the problem with gamers. You hear something and your natural reaction is to be afraid. But then the consequences fall on you. They're talking about cutting Spider-Man into multiple pieces the way they did those teraflops all those years ago. Oh, you're getting a full game. We'll chop it into three pieces and it'll be three games. Meanwhile, on Xbox, we're already talking about the next expansion for Starfield. And I don't gotta buy that shit. All I gotta do is just click on the game. And Power World is gigantic right now. And it's being associated with Xbox the same way Xbox associated itself with live services, same way live services associated itself with Xbox. By no means is live service only on Xbox. It's on many different platforms. But it's called live service because of Xbox. That is the kind of mindshare that PlayStation wants. But because of their fan base, because of the fear-mongering, because of the demonization, a whole audience didn't get to associate itself with that platform. Anyway, guys, tell me what you think. Do you think that games as a service was pointless? Or do you think that it was a big deal this whole time? It was a sleeping giant and people didn't take it seriously. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Don't forget to click that bell. Later, guys.